In this lecture, let's finish the discussion of quadcopters. Let's discuss the yaw motion. That is rotation around the vertical axis. That is the Z axis. We know to keep the rotor hovering in the air, we need four lifting forces from the four rotors. We have F1, F2, F3, F4. The sum of them is equal to the gravity force of the quadcopter. We know rotor 1 and rotor 3 rotates in the clockwise direction. Rotor 2 and rotor 4 rotate in the counterclockwise direction. Now let's decrease the torque of rotor 1 and rotor 3. A decrease in the torque to rotor 1 and 3, it will be a negative disturbance. Based on Newton's law, the negative disturbance will also be applied to the motor mounted on the quadcopter frame. For the rotor, it is a negative disturbance. But for the motor, it will be a positive reaction. It will make motor 1 rotate in a clockwise direction. The same for the motor 3 that is used to control the rotor 3. Then we need to increase the rotational speed of rotor 2 and rotor 4. If we increase or decrease the rotational speed of all four rotors by the same amount, then we know the sum of them will not be changed. Then the quadcopter will not have the vertical motion. Because the rotor 2 and 4 are rotating in the counterclockwise direction. To increase their rotational speed, it is like a negative disturbance. Then the negative disturbance will be a positive reaction for the motor that is used to control the rotational speed of the rotor. Then we have positive reaction for rotor 2, for motor 2, and motor 4. Then this four positive torque reaction torque will make the quadcopter rotate in a clockwise direction around the vertical axis V. Then we know the transfer function from the torque to rotational angle. Phi will be a double integrator model. It'll be 1 over a square. I is the moment inertial.